गणानां त्वा गणपतिगं हवामहे कविं कवीनामुपमश्रवस्तमं ज्येष्ठराजं ब्रह्मणां ब्रह्मणस्पतानः शृण्वन्नोतिभिः सीदसादनं श्रीमहागणाधिपतये नमः। गुरुर्ब्रह्मा गुरुर्विष्णुः गुरुर्देवो महेश्वरः गुरुस्साक्षात् परं ब्रह्म तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः। सदाशिवसमारम्भां शङ्कराचार्यमध्यमाम् अस्मदाचार्यपर्यन्तां वन्दे गुरुपरम्पराम्। ओम्। डियर् फ्रेण्ड्स्, वी आर् सीयिङ्ग् दिस् विवेक चूडामणि। वी रेड् दिस् श्लोका नम्बर् 218 अकार्डिङ्ग् टु शृङ्गेरि एडिशन् एण्ड् 216 अकार्डिङ्ग् टु दिस् रामकृष्ण एडिशन्। दट् ईस् असौ स्वसाक्षिको भावो यतस्वेनानुभूयते अतः परं स्वयं साक्षात् प्रत्यगात्मा न चेतरः। वी रेड् दट् पर्टिक्युलर् श्लोका। द ओवराल् काण्टेक्स्ट् ईस् दट् देर् हेस् बीन् अ डिस्कशन् बिट्वीन् द टीचर् अण्ड् दि स्टूडेण्ट् एण्ड् द टीचर् एक्स्प्लेन्ड् आल् द 5 कोशास् द पञ्चकोश and then he gave reasons why as to why they have to be rejected. They are not the self, they are not the real self. The real self is something different. So when all the 5 selves have been, when all the 5 kosha, call them selves, when all those 5 selves are koshas, they have been rejected, then the shishya has got a valid doubt. So when everything is negated, what remains probably is mithya. Sorry, not mithya, it is shunya. What remains is absolute abhava. Abhava is total non-existence. So that is what he says. And that is a reference to the Shunyavada of the Buddhists. Then the Guru was saying, now if you say that you have rightly thought so, because you have come to the right conclusion, you are very good in enquiry, proper enquiry, and then you have rightly come to the conclusion. But then, when you say that abhava is there, then who is the observer of that abhava? You are the observer of that abhava. So that is what he said. तत्साक्षिकं भवेत् तत्तद् यद्यद् येनानुभूयते। वी सा इन् दट् 215 श्लोक एण्ड् देन् ही हूएवर् हू सीस् वाट् एवर् ही बिकम्स् द विट्नेस् फार् आल् दट् एण्ड् देर् आफ्टर् ही सेड् असौ स्वसाक्षिको अभावो यतस्वेनानुभूयते। सो दिस् असौ अभावः, दिस् पर्टिक्युलर् अभाव, असौ कनेक्ट्स् टु अभाव। अभाव ईस् अभाव आफ् एनिथिङ्ग्, अभाव आफ् एव्रिथिङ्ग् दट् ईस् एब्सल्यूट् नान् एक्सिस्टेन्स्. सो देन् हू ईस् दि साक्षि फार् दिस्? Svasakshikaha. That is, it is having itself as the Sakshi. It is having the self as the Sakshi. It is having itself means not abhava, it is having the self as the Sakshi. Svasakshikaha abhavaha. Sva here refers to self. Svasakshikaha abhavaha. Yataha svena anubhuyate. It is actually experienced by one's own self. Then ataha param svayam sakshat pratyagatma. So the anvaya is like this. You see, so therefore atah it is okay, therefore svayam pratyagatma, this whatever we call this pratyagatma, the innermost self, that is sakshat param, that is sakshat, that is directly, that is the supreme reality, that is the only reality. So that is param means paramatma, you can also say that paramatma. So this svayam pratyagatma, whatever this pratyagatma, whatever you are calling it as pratyagatma, that itself is the supreme atma. Nacha itaraha means it is not something different from Brahman. What you call as supreme, this pratyagatma is not something different from the supreme reality. Nacha itaraha, that is not different from Brahma. So when you negate all these 5 sheets, it looks like abhava, and you are, because you are the knower of that, you are that supreme self. So that is what he says. Then we will go to the next shloka, that is 219 in your book. Jagrat svapna sushuptishu sputataram yosau samujrumbhate pratyagrupataya sadahamahamityantaspuranekadha nanakara vikara bhajina iman pashyannaham dhimukhan nityananda chidatmana spurati tam vidhisvametam hrudi. Very long, what is this called? Shardula Vritta. Shardulam, you know, Shardulam is a tiger. So in Sanskrit, various meters, they have been given various names. One is Shardula. Shardula is comes like a tiger. There is another thing called Matteva. Matteva means a mighty drunken elephant. इट इज लाइक दैट माइटी ड्रंक एन एलिफेंट सो लाइक दैट दिस इज अ शार्दूल जागृत स्वप्न सुषुप्ति सुषु स्फुटतरम योसौ समुज्रंभते नाउ वी आर रेफरिंग टू द असौ असौ इट वाट असौ आत्मा दिस पर्टिकुलर सेल्फ दिस पर्टिकुलर सेल्फ इज समथिंग विच इज समुज्रंभते दिस वर्ड समुज्रंभते वी हैव कम अक्रॉस अर्लियर सम उज्रंभते सम्यक उज्रंभते सो इट शाइन्स इंडिपेंडेंट ऑफ एनीथिंग independent of everything all other things they need something to be to illumine the body mind complex it needs something else to be illuminate whereas this atma is something which is self luminous that is it is independent of everything it shines independent of everything that is what is called samujrumbhate asau this yosau samujrumbhate yaha asau that which यह असौ समुज्रंभते दट विच इज शाइनिंग इंडिपेंडेंटली ऑफ एवरीथिंग एल्स दट ईज जाग्रत स्वप्न सुषुप्तिषु सुषुप्तिषु स्फुटतरम समुज्रंभते इन ऑल द थ्री स्टेट्स इन द जाग्रत अवस्था इन द ड्रीम स्टेट एंड ऑल्सो इन द डीप स्लीप स्टेट दिस पर्टिकुलर आत्मा दिस पर्टिकुलर कॉन्शियसनेस दिस चैतन्यम विच वी कॉल सुप्रीम कॉन्शियसनेस दट इज वॉट ईज से शाइनिंग इंडिपेंडेंट ऑफ एवरीथिंग एंड देन इट इज ऑल्सो सीन प्रत्यग्रूपतया मीन्स प्रत्यक् दट इज इनसाइड प्रत्यग्रूपतया दट इज सीन एज द इनरमोस्ट सेल्फ प्रत्यग्रूपतया इट इज सीन एज द इनरमोस्ट सेल्फ प्रत्यग्रूपतया हाउ वाई 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 डू वी कॉल इट इनरमोस्ट बिकॉज सदा ऑलवेज अहम अहम इति अत्यंत इति अंतः स्फुरन एकधा अहम अहम दट नोशन ऑफ आई 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 It is always throbbing inside. Spuran, antaha, antaha means inside. Spuran, that spuran, the spurana, you can call it throbbing. So I, that notion of I is always throbbing inside. So spuran, ekadha means in a very uniform manner, unchanging manner, in a totally unchanging manner, this I notion is there. Whether you are in the waking state or in the dream state, Of course, in the deep sleep state, you don't have that notion while you are sleeping. But when you get up, you have that notion. Yeah, I slept very well. So that I was, not absent at that time. I was very much present. So this is something which is unchanging. It has got an unchanging presence in all the three states. And then, nanakara vikara bhaginaha. That book says bhajinaha. Shrungeri book says bhajinaha. It doesn't matter. नानाकार विकार भाजिनः नाना आकार आकार मीन्स डिफरेंट शेप्स वन कैन बी ए ह्यूमन बीइंग अनदर अनदर थिंग मे बी एन एनिमल इट कैन बी अ डॉग और अ डोंकी वट एवर इट इज इन सो मेनी शेप्स इवन द डोंकी हैज गॉट द नोशन ऑफ आई अ डॉग हैज द नोशन ऑफ आई बिकॉज वेन यू ट्राई टू हिट इट इट विल बार्क एंड देन इट विल कम बैक इवन अ कैट हैज दैट नोशन ऑफ आई सो दैट नोशन ऑफ आई इज देयर इन एवरी बीइंग Starting from a mosquito also, even when you try to hit a mosquito, that mosquito also runs away. So that aham bhav, aham, that notion of I, aham dhi, what is called aham dhi, aham buddhi, that notion of I is there in all these shapes, nanakara. Then vikara, vikara is, once you have some body, there are vikaras, there are changes within that body. A human being also has got a vikara, that is janma. Then jayate, asti, parinamate, vardhate, apachyate, vinashyati. That shad bhava vikaras which Yaskacharya describes. That is six changes which every being undergoes. Bhava vikara. That is the changes which every being undergoes. They are called the bhava vikaras. So those bhava vikaras, they are there for all the beings. Whether it is a mosquito or an elephant, jayate, asti, vardhate, parinamate, apachyate, vinashyati, etc. They are all there. नानाकार विकार भाजिनः इमान इमान मीन्स दीस इमान इज इन द्वितीय बहुवचनम इमान दृश्यान वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट दीस दृश्य ऑल दीस थिंग्स दे आर समथिंग विच आर नॉट द सेल्फ दीस आर ऑल दृश्य वेदर इट इज जाग्रत अवस्था आर ड्रीमिंग स्टेट आर ए स्वप्नावस्था ऑल दीस आर दृश्य बिकॉज यू आर एबल टू ऑब्जेक्टिफाई दम यू आर एबल टू सी दम सेपरेटली पश्यन अहम धीमुखान दिस नोशन ऑफ आई दिस ईगो What we call ego also is objectified. Also, ego also can be separated. Aham pashyan, aham dhimukhan, iman drushyan pashyan. Anvaya, you can take it like that. Ahamdhi Mukhan, that is the Ahamdhi. Ahamdhi is the notion of I. Mukhan, Ahamdhi, etc. That Mukhan, Pramukha, Mukhan, it is a pratyaya. It says Ahamdhi, etc. Ahamdhi Mukhan, Iman, Drushyan. You have to construe like that. So it is objectifying, this consciousness is something which is objectifying all these things, including this ego, empirical ego. Ahamdhi is that empirical ego. Even that empirical ego is being objectified. And then what is your real nature? That is Nityananda Chidatmana Sphurati. That is, this is something which is Hrudi Sphurati. Sphurati Tam Vidhis Svametam Hrudi. That Hrudi has to be connected to Sphurati. Nityananda Chidatmana Hrudi Sphurati. In one's buddhi, it throbs, it is shining. It shine, you can say shine, because this is a word which for which translation is difficult. Sphurati. Sphurati, you can say it is manifest, it is throbbing, it is shining. You can use any word. So Sphurati, where Hrudi, Hrudi Sphurati, in the buddhi only it is reflecting. What? Nityananda Chidatmana. The real nature is that it is something which is Nitya, and this is of the nature of Ananda. And then Nityananda Chidatmana. It is also of the nature of Chit. Nitya, Ananda, Chit. That is Sat, Chit, Ananda. All the three things are there. Nitya is that Sat. That is beyond, say, Kala Paricheda. Kala Paricheda is the delimitation due to time. Then Ananda. Then this delimitation due to, say, physical spatial limitation, because only something which is spatially delimited, it is having, say, dukkha. When something it is infinite, it is of the nature of ananda. And then chidatmana, it is something which is of the nature of intelligence. And in that intelligence also, what we call prajnana ghana, that is, that differentiated intelligence, it is not differentiated intelligence, where I am knowing this. So that knower known, that Triputi is not there. So that is pure consciousness. In the form of pure consciousness, Nitya, Ananda, Chit, Sat, Chid, Ananda, Atmana, Sphurati, that which is manifest, which is existing, which is, say, shining in that Hrudi, Tam Vidhi Swam, Tam Etam, you realize that is your real self. Tam Vidhi, Vidhi means you know, Swam. Tam Swam Vidhi, that you know it as yourself. That you, Swam Vidhi, that Swam also is in Dvitiya Ekavachanam. Tam Swam Vidhi, you know that as your real self. So that is what it means. Then how to see that? We don't identify with that. We identify with the Chit Pratibimba only. Now he is talking about what is called Chidabhasa. You see, what does Vedanta say? That is, the Supreme Consciousness is something which is reflecting in the Antahkarana. And this reflection of Antahkarana with this Jiva is confusing he is identifying with that. Jiva is identifying with that, and as a result he is identifying with the empirical ego. That Chidabhasa is identifying with that empirical ego. So that is what is happening. So that he is explaining here. You are not that Chidabhasa. You are that Chit alone. Chidabhasa is Pratibimba. Pratibimba is different from Surya. Suppose there is a water in a pot, and then there is sun's, say, Pratibimba, that is reflection. And an ignorant person can mistake it for sun, but that is not the real sun. Real sun is elsewhere. Real sun is something different. It is something distinct. So that is what he is saying in this particular shloka. Ghatodake bimbitam arka bimbam आलोक्य मूढ़ो रविमेव मन्यते तथा चिदाभासम उपाधि संस्थम भ्रांत्या हमित्येव जडोभिमन्यते. घटोदके बिंबितम अर्कबिंबम आलोक्य. आलोक्य मीन्स हैविंग सीन व्हाट. घटोदके बिंबितम अर्कबिंबम, हैविंग सीन द अर्कबिंबम, दट इज द इमेज ऑफ द सन. Where ghatodake bimbitam, that is reflected in the water of, in the pot, reflected in the pot which is there in the water. So there is a pot, there is some water, there is a pratibimba, and then that we are seeing, we some alokya. Then mudaha, an ignorant person, रविम एव मन्यते, ही थिंक्स दैट दैट इज द रवि, दैट इज द सूर्य, ही थिंक्स दैट। देन तथा लाइकवाइज चिदाभासम उपाधि संस्थम, लाइकवाइज व्हाट आर वी डूइंग, देर इज अ चिदाभास, दैट इज द रिफ्लेक्शन ऑफ दिस कॉन्शियसनेस ऑन द बुद्धि, एंड दैट इज चिदाभास, एंड वी आर थिंकिंग दैट पर्टिकुलर रिफ्लेक्शन इज द अवर रियल सेल्फ। चिदाभासम उपा, दैट इज समथिंग विच इज डीलिमिटेड टू अंतःकरण, चिदाभास इज समथिंग डीलिमिटेड टू अंतःकरण, वेर एज प्योर चित् इज नॉट समथिंग डीलिमिटेड, चित् इज नेवर डीलिमिटेड, दिस चिदाभास इज ओनली डीलिमिटेड टू अंतःकरण, एंड देन दिस इज ऑल्सो उपाधि संस्थम। ही सेज उपाधि संस्थम इज इट इज जस्ट रिफ्लेक्टिंग इन दट उपाधि विच इज कॉल्ड बुद्धि, बुद्धि इज हैविंग इज द उपाधि दर आर रादर द लिमिटिंग एडजंक्ट, सो इन दट लिमिटिंग एडजंक्ट दिस कॉन्शियसनेस इज शाइनिंग। एंड देन भ्रांत्या अहमित्येव जडः अभिमन्यते, अभिमन्यते मीन्स ही आइडेंटिफाइज ए पर्सन हु इज ए जड, जड मीन्स हियर अनथिंकिंग पर्सन, ए पर्सन हु डज नॉट डू प्रॉपर एंक्वायरी, सो ही भ्रांत्या आउट ऑफ शियर डेल्यूजन ही थिंक्स अहमित्येव अभिमन्यते, ही थिंक्स दैट दैट इज माय रियल सेल्फ, सो दिस जीवा इज somebody हु इज आइडेंटिफाइंग विद दिस अंतःकरण अवच्छिन्न चैतन्यम जीवः विषे, सो दट अंतकरण अवच्छिन्न चैतन्यम इज दट चिदाभास, दट चिदाभास ही इज आइडेंटिफाइंग विद दट चिदाभास एंड नॉट विद द सुप्रीम रियालिटी विच इज द ओरिजिनल सेल्फ। सो वेन यू डिनाई, वेन यू रिजेक्ट ऑल दीज थिंग्स, वॉट वॉट डज रिमेन, वॉट इज इट दट रिमेन्स, वॉट रिमेन्स इज दट चित्त, चित्त ओनली प्योर चित्त, बट देन वी आर अनफॉर्चुनेटली आइडेंटिफाइंग विद द चिदाभास, सो दट इज वॉट ही सेज। देन नाउ ही सेज वी हैव टू रिजेक्ट ऑल द थ्री एंड देन सी द रियल सन, you have to reject the pot, you have to reject the water, you have to reject the arka bimbam, then what are they, what do they signify? Ghatam represents the grass body, ghata grass thing, isn't it? Ghata represents the grass body, jalam, jalam is slightly more subtle, it is reflect, ghata does not reflect say the sun, jalam reflects the sun, so likewise buddhi is comparable to the jalam. Then arka bimbam, that chidabhasa, Arkabimbam is that reflection of the sun, which is that Chidabhasa. You ignore all the three, he says. So that is what he says. Ghatam jalam tadgatam arkabimbam vihaya sarvam vinirikshyate arkaha tatastha yetat tritaya vabhasakaha swayam prakasho vidushayatha tatha. That is, ghatam, all ghatam jalam tadgatam arkabimbam vihaya. Vihaya means Having rejected, that is lyap pratyaya. So vihaya, having rejected what? Ghatam. Ghatam vihaya, jalam vihaya, tadgatam arkabimbam vihaya. So it applies to all that. That is, ghatam, jalam, all these things are in dvitiya vibhakti. So you have to reject that ghatam. You have to reject that jalam. That is not the real self. Then tadgatam arkabimbam. And the jalagatam, that is that Arkabimbam which is there in the water, that is the reflection of the sun which is there in the water, that also has to be rejected. Vihaya sarvam vinirikshyate arkaha, having rejected all that, the sun is seen. Vinirikshyate samyak ikshyate vi visheshena, your book doesn't say vinirikshyate, what does your book say?
Divivishyate.
Okay, divi means in the sky, in the heaven. Vikshyate, he is seen. Arkaha, arkaha is sun. The sun is vinirikshyate. It doesn't matter. The sun is distinctly seen, or rather the sun is very clearly seen, distinct from these three. So that is what it means. Then tatastaha. That book says tatasthitaha. It doesn't matter. Tatastaha. Tatastha means what? Totally neutral. It has nothing to do with the ghata, it has nothing to do with the jalam, it has nothing to do with the bimbam, etc. It is totally neutral. It is not affected, it is not affecting them, nor is it affected by that. Tatastaha yetat tritaya avabhasakaha. It is the avabhasaka, it is the illuminer for all the three. It is illuminer means it is enabling us to know the ghatam. Ghatam is the body. Once we know the ghatam, you know our results. So it is enabling us to know the ghatam, it is enabling us to know the jalam, that is the mind, it is enabling us to know the what is that chidabhasa, it is illumining all the three. So yetat tritaya avabhasakaha, then of course this particular book this Swamiji writes jagrat swapna sushupti avabhasakah etat tritaya avabhasakah. When we say tritayam, tritayam is the group of three, the illuminer of all the three, illuminer of all the three, he is saying it as jagrat swapna sushupti. So for this say these three can refer to ghatam jalam arkabimbam, or it can also refer to jagrat swapna sushupti. Why, how? Because in the jagrat avastha, the sthula sharira is awake. Sthula sharira, this ghatam, is present. And in the swapna, mind is present, that is jalam. Arkabimbam, that chidabhasa, is there always, isn't it? So like that, jagrat swapna sushupti, that chidabhasa is very much there. So in the, this ghatam, jalam, arkabimbam can also refer to jagrat swapna sushupti. I think this also is good. सो अवभासक स्वयं प्रकाश विदुषा यथा तथा स्वयं प्रकाश दट इज समथिंग विच इज नॉट इल्यूमेंड बै एनीथिंग एल्स घटम इज इल्यूमेंड बै समथिंग एल्स जलम इज इल्यूमेंड बै समथिंग एल्स दट चिदाभास इज ओनली अ रिफ्लेक्शन वेर एज दिस स्वयं प्रकाश दिस प्योर कॉन्शियसनेस इज समथिंग विच इज नॉट इल्यूमेंड बै एनीथिंग एल्स देन दिस विल बी नोन विदुषा विदुषा मीन्स बै द विद्वान दट इज बै अ डिस्क्रिमिनेटिंग पर्सन बै अ पर्सन हू डस एन्क्वायरी प्रॉपर एन्क्वायरी yatha tatha as it is, which is as it is yatha tatha, it is yatha tatha connected to anything else? No. This svayam prakasha vidusha yatha tatha, that is, it is seen as it is. Then, again, he is elaborating on the same thing. Deham dhiyam chit pratibim, yeah, he is also saying, you reject all the three. What is body, then dhi. Now we are not talking about ghatam, jalam, arkabimbam. We are now talking about body, mind and chit pratibimba. We are talking about that. Instead of arkabimbam, we are calling chit pratibimbam. So the next shloka reads, Deham dhiyam chit pratibimbam evam visrujya buddhav nihitam guhayam drashtaramatma namakhanda bodham sarva prakasham sadasadvilakshanam. It is connected to the next shloka. Sadasadvilakshanam nityam vibhum sarvagatam susukshmam antarbahishunyam anantamatmanah vijnaya samyagnijarupametat puman vipapma virajo vimrutyuhu. So he is saying, okay, very dense words, small words, but we have to see the meaning. So here what he says is, you have to reject all the three. The overall meaning of the two shlokas is, you have to reject all the three. And then see the real nature of yours. Vijnaya samyak nijarupam etat. That, in the second shloka it is there. Nijarupam vijnaya. Having realized one's own nature, a person will be vipapma virajaha. Vimrutyuhu. A person will become vipapma. He is freed from papa punya. He is virajaha. That is, viraja is shuddha. No, there is no rajoguna, there is no karma, there is nothing. Viraja means not only Rajoguna, all the three gunas will disappear. And then Vimrutyuhu, he has attained that state of immortality. So that is the last line. So let us see right from the beginning. Deham dhiyam chit pratibimbam evam visrujya. Chit pratibimbam etam. That book says patantaram, doesn't matter. Deham equivalent to ghatam. Deham is body, this is, which is grass. Dhiyam, dhi. Dhi, dvitiya is dhiyam. That is buddhi, which is equivalent to that jalam. And then chit pratibimba metam, this chit pratibimba, this chidabhasa as we call it. Chidabhasa, abhasa is what? Something which is unreal but it is seen. Abhasa. It is only abhasa. In logic they call it hetva abhasa. Hetu is logic, hetu is the reason. And in a discussion, some people sometimes advance a reason. But it is not exactly a valid reason. It is a sort of logical fallacy. It is hetva bhasa. That is a logical fallacy. It appears like a hetu, but it is not hetu. It is apparently hetu. That's all. That is a logical fallacy. So that, like that, chit pratibimbam. It is something which is a reflection of that. Chidabhasa. Chit pratibimbam etam. Etam means this. This book says evam. Evam means in this manner. Visrujya. Visrujya means having rejected. Having rejected. Then buddhav nihitam guhayam. This buddhav nihitam guhayam is the guhayam buddhav nihitam chitta pratibimbam vihaya. दिस इज वी दिस बुद्धौ निहितं गुहायां रेफर्स टू चित् प्रतिबिंबम दिस चित् प्रतिबिंबम विच इज देयर निहितं इन बुद्धि गुहा इज अन्वय क्लियर दिस चित् प्रतिबिंब विच इज निहितं निहितं गुहायां परमे व्योमन वी सी दट इन तैत्तिरीय उपनिषत् सो चित् प्रतिबिंबम निहितं निहितं मीन्स विच इज देयर एग्जिस्टिंग इन बुद्धि गुहा बुद्धौ गुहायां दट इज एग्जिस्टिंग इन दट बुद्धि गुहा सो दट इज बै रिजेक्टिंग दट फॉल्स आई दट फॉल्स ईगो आर द एम्पिरिकल ईगो विच इज द चित् प्रतिबिंब विच इज देयर इन दट बुद्धि विच इज द चित् प्रतिबिंब विच इज देयर इन दट बुद्धि सो चित् प्रतिबिंबम बुद्धौ निहितं गुहायां विहाय देन विहाय द्रष्टारं आत्मानं अखंडबोधं सो नाउ वी आर सीइंग दिस द्रष्टा द्रष्टा इज द सीर द नोवर दट इज नोवर ऑफ व्हाट ही इज द नोवर ऑफ ऑल दीज थ्री ही इज द नोवर ऑफ बॉडी ही इज द नोवर ऑफ माइंड ही इज द नोवर ऑफ चित् प्रतिबिंब नोवर मीन्स ही इज द इल्यूमिनर द्रष्टारं आत्मानं आत्मानं मीन्स द वेरी सेल्फ देन अखंडबोधं अखंडबोध बोध मीन्स नॉलेज consciousness akhanda khanda means a piece akhanda means there is no piece it is one solid that means what there is undifferentiated consciousness in intelligence there is a differentiation isn't it I am knowing this I am knowing an object so I am different and the object is different so there is a knowledge triputi that is knower I mean jnata jnayam and jnanam But here this akhanda bodha is that undifferentiated consciousness where this distinction of knower, known, etc. is not there. Then that is akhanda bodham. It is like that sun's say rays only. That sun's rays is a beautiful example given in Kathopanishad. Sun's rays, they are illumining all the objects. It is not touched by anything. It is something which is totally unaffected by anything. Then sarva prakasham means that which is illumining everything else. And then sadasad vilakshanam. Sat, Asat, Vilakshanam. Suddenly some new words have come. Sat is what is manifest is Sat. That is Prithivyapasteja, they are the Sat. Asat is Vayurakasha, that is Asat. That is one way of saying. The another way of saying is Sat is what all is manifest, including Vayu and Akasha. And Asat is that Maya, Ravyakta, Prakruti. Asat is Prakruti. Because in Gita also we get सदसद्भ्याम नो वट इज दट सदसच्याहमेव च सदसच्या देर इज सम लाइन इन 11th अध्याय 10th अध्याय आल्सो दट इज आई एम सत् असत् एंड बियॉन्ड दट इज वाट कृष्णा सेज दट इज सत् इज समथिंग विच इज मैनिफेस्ट असत् इज अनमैनिफेस्ट दट इज प्रकृति बिकॉज फ्रॉम प्रकृति ओनली ऑल दीज थिंग्स आर मैनिफेस्टिंग एंड देन बियॉन्ड दट सद एंड असत् दट इज दि ब्रह्मन So that is what it is. Sadasad vilakshanam. It is something which is distinct from this manifest and also from the unmanifest. Still the shloka, the line is not completed. It is continuing. So drashtaram, akhandabodham. Then next one line says, nityam vibhum sarvagatam susushvam vijnaya. That is, nityam. Nitya again is, as we just discussed, something which is paricheda shunyam. Nitya is Kala Paricheda Shunyam. It is not delimited by time, Nitya. Then Vibhu. Vibhu means, it is Desha Paricheda Shunyam. Vibhu. Vibhu means, I am not Vibhu. In the sense that I am present here only, I am not in my house. I am present here in India, not elsewhere. So I am something which is delimited by space. So this is something which is not having Desha Paricheda. Vibhu means Sarva Vyapi. That is, there is no Desha Paricheda. Sarva Gatam. It is existing in all, that means it is the upadana karanam for everything. All pervading, that is the upadana karanam for everything. It is the substratum for everything. Then susukshmam, something which is very subtle, because it is something which is not seen, it has to be understood only. Then antar bahishunyam, there is no such thing as inside or outside. What does it mean? Antar bahishunyam means it is something of the nature of infinity. Antaha bahihi. There is nothing called inside, there is nothing called outside. It is there all pervading. Then, antarbhaishunyam, anantam. Anantam again is same thing. Anantam atmanaha vijnaya. Anantam atmanaha vijnaya. So, anantam, that atmanaha, of that atman, vijnaya, having known.
Anunya is
also there. नॉट अनन्य इट इज सॉरी नॉट अनंत इट इज अनन्य शून्यम अनन्यमात्मन अनन्य अनन्य मीन्स इट इज नॉट समथिंग डिफरेंट फ्रॉम यू अनन्यम आत्मन आत्मन अनन्यम इट इज नॉट डिफरेंट फ्रॉम युवर सेल्फ आई डिड नॉट सी प्रॉपर्ली आत्मन अनन्यम दट ईज समथिंग विच ईज नॉट डिफरेंट फ्रॉम युवर सेल्फ सो मेक्स बेटर सेन्स आत्मन अनन्यम That is something which is not different from your own self. And that vijnaya, samyak nijarupam vijnaya, having properly understood your real self, samyak nijarupam vijnaya, having properly understood your real self, etat, then puman means a seeker, let us say, puman actually means a person. A person means, here of course, a seeker. A proper discriminating person, a person who is doing proper enquiry. So he, then vipapma, he becomes sinless. Vipapma, in Vedanta, papa also includes punyam. So vipapma means he is not only sinless, he is also punyamless. There is no positive and negative, all accounts made zero. So that is it. Vipapma, then if there is punyam, he has to go to heaven. So if he is aware of that punyam, If he is having abhimana, if he is having identification with that punyam, he will go to swargam and he will be dancing with somebody. He doesn't have moksham. So, vipapma. Then virajaha. Viraja is? Viraja. Rajas is dirt. Rajas is dirt. Viraja is without any dirt. What? This sattva, rajas, tamoguna, all the three are called rajas. That is the dirt. That is because these three things, they bind a person. These three things, the sattvam, samoguna binds a person, rajoguna binds a person, sattvaguna also binds a person, because sattvaguna facilitates shravana manana nididhyasana, we agree. But then sattvaguna also can bind a person, that is, I am doing some good things, okay, I am doing some charitable work, I am more interested in that charitable work, then I develop some sort of, say, attachment for that. I develop attachment for that and I get identified with that. So that is, I am doing some good work. Oh, I think I am propagating dharma, I am doing this, that, etc., etc. And I forget my own self. And then I am more interested in teaching, maybe writing, etc., etc. So that also is a trap. So sattvagunam can also be a trap because it is also binding. We have to go above sattvaguna also. So virajaha. Vimrutyuhu, at that time he becomes devoid of that mrutyu. Means he becomes that, he attains that amrutatvam. Amrutatvam attaining means what? Then such a person, where there is no punya, papa, etc., etc. What Vedanta says is his linga sharira or whatever that subtle body just disintegrates and merges with the elements. And then he is the chit. This chit is something which is, he is a realized person. He realizes that his nature is not this chit pratibimba, but the actual chit itself. That chit is infinite. He is already in that state. There is no question of chit merging in chit. He is already in that state. So that is how, that is what is moksha. Mrityu, eternal, something which is this sort of transmigration into another body, etc., etc., doesn't take place. Mrityu will be there only when janma is there. That means there is no janma, means there is no mrutyu.
Then, vishoka ananda ghano vipashit, swayam kutaschinna bibheti kashit, then nanyosti pantha bhavabandha mukter vina svatattva vagamam mumukshoho. So this again he is explaining the attitude of what happens to a jnani. A jnani, we have seen in Taittiriya and other Upanishads, jnani becomes fearless. What? Abhayam vai gato bhavati, something like that. Dvitiya dvai bhayam. Then nabibheti kutaschana. So such words we have seen in the Upanishads. That is a person who is not afraid of anything. What does it mean? Is he becomes so bold that he can go and hit anybody? Not that he becomes very bold and he can hit anybody, but that he does not see duality. Dvitiya dvai bhayam. That is, when you are visualizing yourself as a limited entity and you are visualizing somebody else as somebody else, then naturally, there is some sort of personal distance there. You are not trying, you don't want to offend that man and that man doesn't want to offend you. Or You may be entertaining some sort of love or hate or some such relationship with him. Similarly, he also entertains that relationship, and we are not sure about that relationship. So, this perception of duality is what, causes, bhayam, some paranoia, let us say. Americans are supposed to be highly paranoid. So, and they have a theory that only paranoid survive. So like that, this gentleman who is a jnani, he is not paranoid. Jnani is not paranoid because he doesn't see duality. So, Vishokaha, he is devoid of shoka. He is not having any sort of grief. Grief is due to very limited understanding. There is another line which also says, Dukkam nama prajnaparadha eva. That is another beautiful statement from somewhere. Dukkam nama prajnaparadha eva. That is, if somebody is having dukkha, it is some sort of incorrect understanding. Prajna aparadham. Something a wrong understanding. If you are having proper analysis and proper understanding, you will not have dukkha, you will not have grief for anything. So when you are having dukkha, it means that there is some sort of psychological inadequacy, there is some sort of misunderstanding. So we have to understand things properly, analyze things properly, then see the real nature. Once we see the real nature, that shoka goes away. So Vishokaha, Ananda Ghanaha, like what we saw, Akhanda Bodham. We saw that Akhanda Bodha in an earlier sloka. Same thing is Ananda Ghana. Ananda is bliss, Bodha, Ghanaha. So earlier Akhanda Bodha, that is undifferentiated consciousness. Here it is undifferentiated Ananda. That is Ananda Ghanaha. It is Ananda Ghanaha. What is this undifferentiated Ananda? Vishayananda is there. So you contrast this Vishayananda with Brahmananda. We have seen these two words earlier. Somewhere earlier in the beginning of the text, we saw this distinction between Vishayananda and Brahmananda. Vishayananda is the happiness. I just get into some Anandamaya Kosha when I am eating some nice lunch. And when I am paying the bill, I come out of Anandamaya Kosha. So that is Vishayananda. So Vishayananda is something which is caused temporarily, and then you forget yourself, and then you are in that kosha. Vishayananda is only a kosha. But this is not a kosha. It is, in Vishayananda there is something called a person who is enjoying, and then there is an object of enjoyment. But here that object is not there. This is not something which is objectified enjoyment, but it is of the nature of Ananda. You are happy without anything. Like the Taittiriya Upanishad says in Ananda Mimamsa, Shrotriyasya cha akamaha tasya. Where a person who is beyond desire, a person is absolutely, he is beyond desire because he is in that level of infinity. So he doesn't need anything. He doesn't desire anything. So for such a man, he is in a blissful state. So Shrotriyasya cha akamaha tasya. If you see that Ananda Mimamsa, they describe Manushananda, Gandharvananda, Karmadevananda, then again Ajanajanamanandaha, then like that it goes on describing various levels of Ananda. And at every level he says, Shrotriyasya cha kamahatasya, that is the Shrotriya who is an akamahata, he is having the same Ananda. So like that. So then Ananda Ghanaha, Vipaschit is one who can see properly. Pashya, Pashya Dhatu, you see. Pashya is to see. Vipaschit. So properly a person who has clear vision. And then Swayam Kutaschit Na Bibheti Kaschit. He is not afraid of anything because Vitiyadvai Bhayam. He is not afraid of anything in the sense he doesn't see duality. Then Nanyosti Pantha Bhavabandha Muktehe. Apart for this Nanyosti Pantha, there is no other path. Nanyah pantha vidyate yanaya, we say in Purusha Sukta every day, Nanyah pantha vidyate yanaya, prajapatishcharati garbhayanta, etc., etc. So like that, Nanyosti pantha, there is no other way for what? For bhavabandha mukti, that is for release from this bondage of birth. Bondage of birth means bondage of birth and death. Then what is the pantha? Vina svatattva vagamam. Svatattva vagamam vina nanyah pantha. That is, there is no other path other than knowing your own self. Vina sva tattva avagamam. Except knowing, vina here means except. Except knowing your own nature, there is no other way. nanyosti pantha. Apart from knowing your own, your real nature, there is no other way. For whom? For mumukshuhu, mumukshoho, for a mumukshu. Then he is elaborating the same thing. Brahma bhinnatva vijnanam bhava mokshasya karanam yena advitiyam anandam brahma sampadyate budhah. Brahma bhinnatva vijnanam bhava mokshasya karanam. So bhava mokshasya karanam. Bhava is birth. Moksham is release. That is release from this birth. That is liberation. Bhava mokshasya karanam. The cause for that liberation is what? Brahmabhinnatva vijnanam. This realization that aham brahmasmi. Realization that this self is not different from this Brahman. Brahma abhinnatva vijnanam. That is the realization that the self is not different from that Brahman. Is the cause for this samsara vimukti. The cause for release from this samsara. Yena, by which advitiyam anandam. Advitiya. Advitiya is again devoid of any duality. Dvitiya is second, duality. Advitiya, that is something which is devoid of duality. Then that particular ananda, anandam brahma, sampadyate budhaha. Budhaha, budhaha means the seeker, an intelligent person. Sampadyate, sampadyate means he attains. Not only attains, he becomes. Because we say brahmavit brahmaiva bhavati, we say. So he attains brahma means he becomes brahman. That is, he has his individual ego. What is called that individuated consciousness? You see, in that supreme consciousness, which is compared to the ocean or something like that, in that ocean of consciousness, a small thought arises. And that small thought is what is called jiva. That thought is the individuated consciousness, as some people write. Individuated, we don't know whether it is there in English or not, but then that word is used, individuated consciousness. So that individuated consciousness disappears. And he remains as pure consciousness. So that is what it is. Brahma sampadyate budhaha. This personal ego, this empirical ego disappears. And then he remains as that supreme reality. Aham brahmasmi is, repeatedly I keep saying that, aham brahmasmi is not an egotistical statement. It is a statement which is arising out of realization that the empirical ego is totally gone. When the empirical ego is totally subdued, not only subdued, it has totally disappeared, only then aham brahmasmi awareness is there. It is only an awareness. This man does not say. It is only an awareness that, yes, I am that. So that is it. Then again, this man doesn't go about saying aham brahmasmi, etc. So then, brahma sampadyate budhaha. Then, brahma bhutastu samsrutyai vidvanna vartate punaha. Vijñātavyamatassamyak brahmā bhinnatvamātmanah. So here now we are getting some echoes to various Upanishad Vakyas. There is a Upanishad Vakya which says, nasa punara vartate, realized person does not come back. There is a Upanishad statement. I don't remember what Upanishad it is. There is a Upanishad statement. Then this is the reflection of that. This is an echo, let us say. Brahma bhutastu, that is, tu, here is a very emphatic way of saying, this brahma bhutaha, a person who has become brahma. So you see, now we use the word brahma bhutaha, that is, one, a person who has become brahman. Sometimes when somebody dies, we use the term brahmi bhutulu, he has become brahmi bhuta, that is, he has become brahman. God knows whether he has become brahman or not, we use the word brahmi bhuta. Swargastha also we use the same thing. So when we say somebody is a swargastha, then it means that this man is, he has gone to heaven and then he is enjoying pleasures. Brahmi bhuta is a slightly higher stage. So suppose you are referring to a saint, we don't say swargastha because this saint does not recognize swarga. Suppose there is a sannyasi. That sannyasi doesn't recognize swarga. He recognizes it as a very, very lower level of understanding. So his level of understanding is that there is only one supreme consciousness. So he is in that level. So when the body falls off, he is Brahmi Bhuta. His body was technically present. And then when the body has fallen off, the mind complex also disintegrates. That Linga Sharira disintegrates. And then he is one with the Brahman. So then we say Brahmi Bhuta. So that word here it is used. Brahma Bhutastu samsrutyai na avartate panaha. Brahma Bhutaha vidvan. Vidvan means jnani. विद्वान हियर इज अ ज्ञानी नॉट ए सीकर न आवर्तते पुनः ही डज नॉट रिटर्न फॉर वॉट संस्मृत्यै संस्मृति इज ट्रांसमिग्रेशन ही डजंट कम बैक देन अतः देयरफॉर विज्ञातव्यम विज्ञातव्यम अतः अतः इज देयरफॉर विज्ञातव्यम इज इट हैज टू बी नोन वॉट सम्यक् ब्रह्माभिन्नत्वम् आत्मनः आत्मनः ब्रह्मा अभिन्नत्वम् सम्यक् ज्ञातव्यम् दैट इज वन हैज टू नो द नॉन डिफरेंस बिटवीन अभिन्नत्वम् दैट नॉन डिस्टिंक्शन बिटवीन ब्रह्मन एंड वन्स ओन सेल्फ वेरी वेरी प्रॉपरली सो दैट इज व्हाट दिस श्लोक इज देन अगेन वी आर अगेन रेफरिंग टू तैत्तिरीय उपनिषद तैत्तिरीय उपनिषद डिस्क्राइब्स ब्रह्मन एज सत्यम ज्ञानम अनंतम ब्रह्म यो वेद निहितम गुहायां परमे व्योमन एट्सेट्रा एट्सेट्रा सो दट सत्यम ज्ञानम अनंतम ब्रह्म ही इज से कोटिंग सत्यम ज्ञानम अनंतम ब्रह्म विशुद्धम विशुद्धम परम स्वतः सिद्धम नित्यानंदैकरसं प्रत्यग भिन्नम निरंतरम जयति सो सत्यम ज्ञानम अनंतम ब्रह्म सो दिस इज वेरी वेरी ग्रेट स्टेटमेंट which say distinguishes our entire philosophy from all other Western philosophy or religion. Because this is one line which has impacted our idea of what we are worshipping every day. Because we are understanding the supreme reality at a totally different level. For example, for the Abrahamic religions, let us say, their understanding of the supreme reality is that there is a God. There is a God who is sitting somewhere in heaven. He is a personal God. He interacts with people. He comes now and then he interacts with this man, that man, etc. He speaks to them and then he also gives some boons, etc. He favors a particular tribe. Then he hates another tribe. He wants to condemn another tribe. So this is a sort of tribal conceptualization of whatever is reality. It's a totally tribal level of understanding. But Upanishadic people, they did not think in tribal terms. They did not have an agenda, as I keep on saying, they did not have an agenda to establish an organized religion as we see nowadays. Their idea was only to know what is the supreme reality. So if you just logically and honestly think, what do you arrive at? You will arrive at certain points. Okay. I am existing, you are existing, something, some object is existing. So we see that there is existence, existence, existence. Sat, 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 sat. Satyam does not mean truth here. We see this, na sato vidyate bhavo, na bhavo vidyate sataha, that second adhyaya, 16th shloka of Gita. There, Shankaracharya has written a very big commentary on what is this sat. Ghatasan, patasan, etc., etc. But sun, that sat, 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 that sadbhavaha, that is the notion that something exists, that is there always, in all the things what is anusyuta, it is there pervading in all the things that sat, sat, sat is there. So sat is something which is pure existence. Existence not only now, then what about existence in the past? And what about existence in the future? Bhutam bhavishyad, bhutam bhavat bhavishyam, everything. That is, whatever was there, whatever is now, whatever is going to come, everything is tat sarvam omkara eva, as Mandukya Upanishad says, that is that principle of existence which is beyond time. That is trikala badhyam we say. That is the past, present and future, this is something which is beyond time. That is what is satyam. Then again Shankaracharya gives the argument, when you say something which is, this is existing, 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 etc., then is it insentient? Is it something which is jada? That question may come. So that is why this word jnanam is added by the Upanishadic Rishi. You see how logically, how very meticulously they thought about what can be the nature of supreme reality. They did not think that there is somebody who is sitting there in heaven, somebody who is controlling you, etc., etc. Not like that. That is at the level of religion. So that they accepted all those things, okay, you do whatever you want at the empirical level. But at a higher level, this is the truth. So when you come to the highest class, this is the truth. So this satyam is something which is not insentient, it is not jada. So that is why they said it is something which is of the nature of jnanam. Satyam, jnanam, jnanam. And when we say jnanam, there again there can be a question. That is, jnanam, I do have jnanam. I have a jnanam about this cup. That is, I am there as an observer. this is something which is the observed, or I am the knower and this is the known, and there is a process called knowledge. Is it that type of knowledge we are referring to? If I am referring to that type of knowledge, then that Brahma is also somebody who is a limited being, isn't it? Brahma will be a limited being knowing something else, like you and me. I am knowing something else, something. You are knowing something. Brahma, okay, he may be knowing all the world. He may be knowing, say, every what is there in your mind, what is there in a mosquito's mind, what is there in a tiger's mind, etc., etc. So Brahma may be knowing all those things, but he is also a limited person. If I have read 1,000 books, Brahma might have read millions and millions of books, let us say. So Brahma will also be a limited person. So Brahma cannot be this sort of knower, known, knowledge relationship. That Jnana Triputi should not be there. So that is beyond that Triputi. And that is why Satyam Jnanam Anantam, it is said, Ananta, that is something which is of the nature of infinite. And that is what is Brahman. And we say, when we use the word Satyam, Jnanam, Anantam, they are not masculine, they are not feminine, they are just used as entity. It is just an entity called consciousness. It is a word which is in neuter gender. It is a neuter gender. So that is what is Satyam, Jnanam, Anantam, Brahma. Then Vishuddham. Vishuddha is, it is something which is unaffected by any karma phala. Then Param. Param is that supreme. Svatas Siddham, that is something which is existing by itself. That is what is illumining everything else. Then Nityanandaikarasam, that is something Ananda we discussed just now. Nitya Anandaikarasam, that is totally Anandaikarasam, is totally unalloyed. Unalloyed Ananda. Then Pratyagabhinnam, that is something which is not different from what is your innermost self. Pratyagabhinnam Nirantaram Jayati. It is there, Nirantaram. Nirantaram again is infinite only. Antaram means a gap, a small recess. Nirantaram, something which is there always. Nityanandaikarasam, it is such a continuum, let us say. So that sort of continuum of Ananda, that is what remains great. Jayati means what remains great. So we'll continue in the next class. Harihi Om Tat Sat.